All right. Hello. My name is Ryan Puffer. I'm a program manager here on the Azure management team. And today I'm really excited to talk to you about Azure Arc enabled servers. When we think about customers today, we have customers who are going and beginning or are already far along their IT modernization journeys. They've started taking their old on-premises applications and packaging them up in containers or moving to serverless, taking those stuff that was on-prem and moving it to co-loads data centers or other clouds, perhaps even multiple clouds. And as these applications continue to diversify and the different frameworks in which we're using to go and deploy and manage them continue to multiply, governing and keeping an eye on all of these resources becomes very difficult. At Microsoft, we're trying to take a look at this problem and figure out what can we do to help bring some control back. So you got stuff running in multiple clouds, some stuff that's going to stay on-prem because of compliance reasons or just, you know, capital expenditure, you already spent it, let's just keep it there. How do we go and bring all that together in one view so that we actually continue to have a good idea of all the applications we're running and how they're managed? So let's talk about kind of how we solve this problem in Azure. So if you've deployed machines or really any resource in Azure today, you're going to have kind of a similar problem because your company may have a subscription, multiple subscriptions, and each team's going to go deploy resources. You still got to figure out how to govern those centrally. And that's where Azure Resource Manager comes in. Resource Manager is the central control plane for Azure. When you go through the portal or command line and you're asking to go create or change something about your resources, Azure Resource Manager is the component responsible for actually accessing that request, deciding what to do with it, and handing it off. So it provides a common set of controls. So if we think about role-based access control to make sure that only the right people can go and create new resources and access existing ones, tagging and inventory to go keep track of, you know, which departments own which resources, templates to go and actually do deployment of multiple things at a single time, because a lot of things at the cloud scale are going to happen with multiple machines. And of course, logs and policy to keep an eye on what did happen and prevent bad things from happening. And that's a great story for Azure, because when you go and do things like trying to onboard to Azure Monitor or Azure Security Center, Azure Resource Manager has a view of all your resources. So we can make that a one-click experience. We know of your virtual machines. We know which ones are not onboarded. And we can provide that information to you right up front and help coordinate the installation of the agent that's needed to onboard to those services. What about the stuff that's not running in Azure, though? The stuff you got on-prem and in other clouds. So those resources today are running in your own environments that you control. Got your own admin tools going and accessing them, and they're entirely disconnected from the Azure infrastructure. But we can fix that with Azure Arc. So Azure Arc as a whole is trying to connect things that are on-prem or in other clouds and project them into Azure Resource Manager so that Azure is aware of them. And once Azure is aware of them, we can actually start providing a lot of the same management and monitoring and governance capabilities that you have in Azure today for the things that are running outside of Azure. So let's talk a little bit about what those scenarios could be. First, inventory and just awareness of all those assets. When you project resources into Azure Arc, you get visibility into their operating system and just the fact that they exist. You can use tags to coordinate, you know, which department they belong to. And, you know, we support Linux and Windows, VMs and bare metal machines. Doesn't really matter where the machine is running, as long as it has internet connectivity, we can project it up into Azure Arc. Once it's there, we can do at-scale management. So we can do things like deploy agents to your machines on-prem from Azure at scale using our command line tools or ARM templates. And then lastly, we can start applying Azure policy to these machines. Previously, to get visibility into the compliance status of a machine that's running in Azure, you used Azure policy. That was not available for things on-prem because they weren't in Azure. We didn't have an understanding of what they were. But with the Azure Arc agent, we are now able to get visibility and start auditing the settings of your machines running on-prem and combine them up into a dashboard in Azure for you to see in one single place. Let's talk a little bit more about that scenario. you're one of these customers on this journey towards multi-cloud. You got a ton of IT sprawl. Developers are using all kinds of new tools, and you just want to get an idea, are we compliant? When the auditor comes by, how do we prove to them that, yes, this setting is as it should be? And that's very hard when you've got a heterogeneous environment of Windows and Linux, different clouds on which each of those machines is running, probably different admins who are managing them. And so the idea here with Azure Arc is by projecting that machine up into Azure, allowing it to start being monitored by Azure policy, we can provide the central IT folks a single page where they can go see the compliance status of all the machines, whether they're in Azure or not. And we also provide benefits to the server admin, because now they can go to the portal and check with a very easy to use interface how they're doing for compliance before the next audit. And they can start doing some management with some other Azure tools on that machine as well, all in a single place. So unifying and simplifying the management experience is really the goal here with Azure Arc. Another good example is onboarding to Azure Monitor. Azure Monitor is kind of the stepping stone to a lot of different Azure services like Security Center and Sentinel for security purposes, change in inventory tracking for keeping an idea of what software is installed in your enterprise. All you got to do first is get your logs up into Azure. And you do that with the Azure Monitor agent. And you can use that with hybrid machines today. You just got to go install the agent yourself using your own tools. We want to make that a whole lot easier. So with Azure Arc and Azure Policy, you can set up a policy on your subscription that says, hey, every time someone goes and adds a new machine, whether it's in Azure or not, please make sure that we install the Azure Monitor agent and make sure it sends its logs to the right spot. We don't want to go anywhere. We want to go to a very specific log analytics workspace. So when someone goes and installs Azure Arc, simple agent installation, Azure Policy will find that new machine and go and automatically deploy the agent to it. We'll take care of downloading the latest version of the agent, configuring it, and reporting back up to Azure whether that was successful or not. So super easy at-scale deployment of that Azure Monitor agent with zero touch from the admins of that machine. Plus, you get the benefit of Azure Policy where you can then go and quickly see the status of the deployment across your enterprise. So that's just one example of how taking an on-prem machine and projecting it up into Azure makes it a whole lot easier to manage those machines without actually changing anything about how that server was previously managed. Let's go and actually take a look at how we get started with Azure Arc. So Arc itself is just an agent. As long as you have access to a machine, you can go and install the agent on Linux or Windows, and you just have to connect it up to your Azure subscription. So all we need from you is just authorization to go and project it up, and then all the other capabilities we just discussed will start being available for that machine. So let's walk through a demo of how this happens. All right, to onboard your machine to Azure Arc, we'll get started here in the Azure portal. We'll go to Servers Azure Arc. You can also search for this up at the top. Here you'll see a list of all your Arc servers, but we'll go ahead and add a new one. When you add a server, you're generating a script that will run on the machine. So we'll select the subscription and resource group where we want to project the Arc-enabled server. We'll pick the region where we want metadata to be stored and the operating system we're installing on. It's important to note that region does not dictate where your machine is physically running. It's just where your metadata will be stored. Next up, we'll work on some tags. So I mentioned earlier, Azure Resource Manager supports tagging your Arc machines. You can choose to automatically assign tags as soon as the machine is onboarded right here. So you'll see that I marked this machine as having me as the owner, its role as a file server, and its physical locations in our Boston data center. With all that in place, we'll go ahead and review the new script we just generated. We can go and download or copy this to our machine, and from there we can start onboarding. So let's head on over to a Linux machine that we want to project up into Azure. So we've got the script downloaded, now we just need to run it. So we'll go here and execute that. Behind the scenes, this is really just downloading and installing our agent on this machine. It will then configure it and project it into the resource group we selected. As part of that, it has to authenticate. So by default, it's going to ask for me to log in using my phone and a device code. But you can also, when you get to at scale onboarding and you're going to bring on multiple machines, you can use the service principle from AAD for a non-interactive automatable experience. Now that this machine's online, let's go and query the agent and just double check that everything's all in order. Here we can see in the middle, agent status is connected. That is all we need to see to know that this machine has internet connectivity, it's been able to reach Azure, and when we go into the portal, we'll now see a projected reference of this on-premises Linux server. All right, and so we just saw how we were able to go and easily onboard that Linux machine up into Azure Arc. It's now going to go start evaluating those Azure policies and install that Azure Monitor agent so that we can get visibility into what's going on that machine. But while it does that, let's take a look at an existing machine I onboarded previously to Azure Arc to see what kind of data we're able to see about it and what we can do to manage it from the Azure portal. So we'll go to Arc Demo Win 01, and we'll see that this machine looks just like an Azure VM. We have information about its computer name, its operating system. You'll see I've tagged it already to identify where it runs, and it's in the HR department. So this is all great tools to let you get a quick view into the machine. But let's drill into policy, because that's one of the unique features you get when you're running an Azure Arc-enabled server. So here is the server admin view of all the policies in scope for their machine and their current compliance status. So compliance status is reevaluated regularly and updated here in the portal. So this server admin knows that whatever this policy is, they're non-compliant. So let's drill in. This policy is checking, is this machine joined to the corporate domain? Very important to ensure that the group policy is actually applied correctly, including all their security settings and, you know, intended configurations, but this machine's not joined to the right domain. Either it's workgroup joined or joined to some other domain. So this machine's out of compliance. As a server admin, I now know this is something I need to take care of and go address. So it's really easy for the server admin to kind of understand what all is going on. From the central IT perspective, Azure policy is also very powerful because they can see the view for all the machines. So we'll see here overall, out of my 108 assets and my subscriptions, only 23% are fully compliant. So let's drill in. If we go to the compliance tab, we can go and see all the policies which we have non-compliant assets. And you'll see here, we got all kinds of different types of policies. Some of them are for Azure machines, some of them are for both Azure and hybrid machines. Let's go take a look at, for example, the time zone policy here. So we asked all of our Windows machines to be set to the Eastern time zone. You'll see here that of our 25 resources that are Windows VMs, 13 of them are not compliant. And I can go here on this page and find a full list of them. You'll see it's a mix of both Azure virtual machines and hybrid virtual machines. So we know, hey, we got to go through here and address these problems. And Azure policy is very flexible, so we got a ton of built-in policies for you to start with, but you can also write your own custom policies to match whatever your internal or regulatory requirements may be. So this is just the beginning. We definitely hope you get a chance to go and deploy Azure policy and really get a great view into how you're doing compliance-wise for all of your assets, no matter where they're running. Back over to the Arc server. I just want to show a few more things. First, here on the Insights tab, when you upload your logs to Azure, you can also opt into Insights for Azure Arc. And Insights shows you things that might be useful to an app developer, like what are the network connections my machine is making? And you can track down here the ports it's reaching and the actual individual servers it's been talking to. And on the Performance tab, of course, you can also see how the resource utilization has been. So if there's been any spikes, you can drill down into this data and figure out maybe that's why the app had crashed. But really powerful feature of Azure Monitor is you can actually go and take that broad view again and say across all my machines in this resource group, how am I doing? And so you'll see here that we had a spike on Arc Demo Win 01, but the other machines weren't spiking quite as much. So that's kind of one of those things you might want to look into. And that's really kind of showing again once you onboard a machine to Arc, there's a lot of grouped tooling and capabilities for the server admin, but the data is flowing elsewhere in Azure to go and provide those broad at-scale management experiences as well. Cool, so let's head back and check one more thing, and that is update management. Update management has been available for hybrid machines for quite some time now, but with Azure Arc, we can pull the view right here for the server admin to take a look at. We'll see we're missing quite a few updates, so right from this page, we can go and schedule those updates to be deployed. I can give an update deployment name, so I'll say Ignite Updates, and we can go pick a schedule. We'll do this on Sunday so we don't disrupt anyone today. So we'll go pick that on the calendar. You can choose exactly which updates you want to install and configure any scripts that need to run before or after to keep your app running. And then we'll go ahead and schedule that. And so now on Sunday, this machine will go ahead and get the updates it's missing. And we'll be able to see it right here on the history tab once the update run has gone through. So really nice, powerful way to go and see how are my machines doing without actually having to sign into the individual machine. Lastly, let's take a look at extensions. So extensions I mentioned earlier are a great way to get the monitoring agent deployed down to a machine. You'll see here we got a couple different extensions already pushed down. First two were by policy, third one was done custom. So let's take a look at what that experience is like. If we wanna go push a script down to this machine, we can do custom script extension, go ahead and create. We'll browse to a file that goes and configures the website in IIS. That's all it has to do. And we'll go ahead and ask Azure to go and download that script to the machine, and it will go and configure it. So nice and easy way to go push down single scripts. There's also a DSC configuration option, as well as the monitoring agent deployment, which you can all coordinate all of these at scale through the Azure command line, ARM templates, or Azure policy. All right, and so you just saw a great demo of how easy it is to go get started with Azure Arc enabled servers and use some of the features that it enables in the Azure portal. Again, all of this stuff is also available through our command line and REST APIs. So when you start thinking about your at scale deployment, we're there for you. We'll make it really easy to do whatever you need to onboard your machines to Azure Arc. And so if you're ready to get started, we got great documentation available on our site at aka.ms/arc/server. If you also want to try one of our jumpstart scenarios, we have a GitHub repo full of ready-to-use Azure Arc scenarios that fit very common customer use cases. So for example, if you've got a couple machines running on another cloud and you want to figure out how do I onboard those at scale using that cloud's tooling to Azure Arc, the Jumpstart repo has a solution for that already, and you can play around with that and get an idea of how to instrument that for your own environment. So definitely a great place to look for some examples of how to get started with Azure Arc. And lastly, we post regularly to the Azure Arc blog, so definitely keep an eye there. We got plenty of good content planned for the rest of the year to, you know, help you get started and get using all the various Azure Arc features. So thanks again for listening. This is Ryan Puffer from the Azure Management team. Hope you enjoyed it.